Hey there, Andrew Kosko with Andrew Kosko of Real Estate and Right at Home Realty. Wanted to talk to you today for those home buyers out there and offer a few tips in the home buying process so that you could be the best prepared for seeking out that wonderful home and that wonderful lifestyle that you are looking for. First and foremost, get your finances sorted. This is a lot more than just doing the online calculating tool that many major banks and lenders out there have on their websites. You should really seek out a mortgage broker. And if you do need one, I have a couple that I'm happy to recommend. But a mortgage broker has access to those products and services, including those within the major banks and others. They can really get you a pre-approval and give you confidence in your financial capacity to buy a home. With that, you can go on the home search with confidence. There's nothing more disappointing than working with a client who has found what they feel is the home that meets their needs, only to get through to the approval process and suddenly there has been a change or the actual approval just wasn't there at that moment in time. So the second thing that you can do after you've got the approval is really start to nail down that wish list. This is kind of more than just, oh, I'm looking for 3 bedrooms and 2 bathrooms. It is really kind of thinking out the length of time you plan on having the home, the improvements that you may or may not want to do, and where you are in that chapter of life in general. Are you newly married? Are you looking to build a family? And if so, how many kids might you want over the next kind of 3 to 5 years? Are you now saying bye to those kids and they're heading off to university and now you're looking for a little less space or actually a different functional space? Maybe the home and the yard is too much and you're considering some condos because you're going to do some traveling and you really don't want to mow the lawn. So as you're kind of thinking through the wish list, this is a little bit of a preliminary activity, but really start to think about what is the lifestyle that we really want to have and what kind of home would meet that lifestyle. This includes geography. Are schools important to you? Are local restaurants or a walk to the lake important to you? When you've got that beta wish list ready and you feel that you're good to go, now is about that time that I would highly recommend you speak to a real estate professional. Yes, I am recommending that because I am in real estate, but more so because that's what we're there for. For many buying clients, for most buying clients, the buying process actually doesn't cost anything. And the earlier you can get a real estate professional on your side, consulting you, advising you, feeding you information, the better it is for your overall home search. There's plenty of information on the internet, yes. A real estate professional can help you navigate through that information. No one should be hiding that information. You should be able to read anything you want, but we spend every day looking at this information and we're able to tell you where there's nuances in the data or in the geography that you may or may not know. So seek out that real estate professional, do some interviews, make sure it's a good fit for you. Then you want to start your home search. And really, this is kind of twofold. You'll want to kind of cast that broad net. You'll get information from your realtor. You'll take the information from your finances and your wish list, and then you'll just start looking around. Very quickly, you'll probably find the things that you like and you don't like about some of the homes or the location and the geography. As you do that, fine-tune your search, and you'll get to a place where you find the one that you're looking for. Before you get there, my last tip would be to develop a strategy with your professional on what you're going to do in the offer stage. Negotiating will be done by your salesperson. They will tell your story and they will sell your offer to the selling client. However, talking about a strategy beforehand, what is your pricing strategy? How many times do you want to go back and forth? What are you willing to spend on certain styles of homes? Knowing that in advance will help you when you get to the home that you're interested in. It'll also help your real estate professional keep you on track so that you don't get caught up in the moment and make a decision that you might regret later on. So again, with those kind of steps in mind, most of my home buying clients have found that the preparedness of doing these things has eased the home buying decision-making process and really resulted in finding that home faster at the end of the day. So I hope it's helpful for you. Again, if you have any questions, please reach out. I'm happy to help in any way I can, and I look forward to seeing you in the future. Bye for now.